Hello and welcome to part two of the 125-year-old drop hammer restoration. Let's go over where we are and where we need to be. So today we're going to be stripping this base down to bare metal and getting everything nice and cleaned up. And then from there, we'll be working on cleaning up each of these dogs, fixing threads, wire reeling, getting them stripped down as well. And then we'll go from there. So let's get to it. So here we've got the base flipped up, gonna clean up the top, and then we'll flip it around, do a once around everywhere else, and clean up any remaining paint, and then we'll move on from there. Now at this point, we're just gonna work on cleaning up these dogs and all the related parts. So on each of these bolts, you've got some numbers, 1 through 4, which correspond with numbers stamped into our base. Up top here, it also looks like we've got something similar with some center punch marks. And we've got a center punch mark on top as well. And that seems to match up to these bolts. So my guess is everything is set up this way so you can eliminate any sort of errors with repeatability, that if you're always putting the same dog in the same place each and every time, you can get more accurate centering, in theory. And then other than that, just have to do a little bit of welding on this bolt. Got some nasty gouges in there, and almost looks like it's some sort of pattern or something on there. I can't quite tell. And additionally, I'm gonna have to get some of these extra nuts. These fit on the bottom. So when you go to fit up this dog in the hardy hole, we'll call them, the whole idea is that you thread a nut underneath to keep it really cinched down and locked down. Once again, probably to eliminate any errors with repeatability. Well, we've got all the heavy parts pretty well cleaned up, and that's pretty much all there is for part two. In part three, we're going to be covering the clutch mechanism and all the other mechanical aspects of this hammer. So I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Any questions, comments, or concerns can be left in the comments section down below. Check us out online, ironwolfindustrial.com, and also on Facebook and Instagram, both at Iron Wolf Industrial. And other than that, thanks for watching the video. Work hard, stay humble.